guys, it's Myles, Nightclub Photography TV, and this is episode 5. Just like I promised you guys in episode 4, I'd get this episode out to you on time and we'd be back on track. Again, sorry for the delay last week, it was very hectic. So now, in episode 5, what we want to cover and get into are more of the details and the specifics on how to take really good nightclub photos. Now, before we get into it, it's very important that you guys understand there really are no black and white settings. I can't tell you, use this aperture setting, use this shutter speed, and use this ISO, and you're always going to get great photos. The truth is, lighting conditions in all clubs differ, and it changes by the second with different strobes and different lighting effects inside the club. So, you know, it's hard for me to tell you that there are black and white settings. There really aren't. Everything is gray, and there's overlapping settings, and if I tell you something, it may work for one club, and another club, it doesn't. So getting into this, there are 4 areas that you need to keep in mind, and it would take forever for me to explain every single scenario, every single setting and variation. So what we're going to do in these videos is take a specific area and cover maybe a few things, or like one area, little by little, for each of those specific areas. And as we move on and we have more episodes, you'll build a better understanding, a more comprehensive understanding. So what are those 4 different areas? Obviously, you have to understand shutter speed and how that affects your nightlife photos. You have to understand aperture, how that affects the look, and ISO settings, your ISO. So those form the three major areas that affect your exposure. And in nightlife photography, exposure and lighting are the most important aspects to keep in mind in the back of your head. But in line with all the episodes that we've been talking about, kind of flash diffusers, flash, and also understanding lighting in interviews with Tyler, Doug, and Francis from episode 4, there's a 4th area that you guys have to understand, and that is called flash exposure compensation. And that deals with your flash. And so if you're taking photos without your flash, this doesn't apply, but most of the time you're going to be using your flash unit, and you have to understand flash exposure compensation. Now, without getting technical, just kind of dumbing it down, it's just like your exposure in your camera, but now it deals with your flash. It can make your pictures a little bit brighter, it can make your subjects a little bit dimmer. It deals with your flash. And if you want to get very general about it and describe it another way, it's kind of like your flash power. If you decrease flash exposure compensation, your FEC value, it's going to be, your subject is not going to be lit up as much from your flash. So that's kind of a quick and dirty way to put it. Again, we don't have to get technical about it. And so understanding your shutter speed, your aperture, your ISO, and your flash exposure compensation are very important so that you guys can produce really good nightclub photos. Now, how does it work? What's flash exposure compensation? If you're using a digital SLR and you have a good flash unit, so right now I have a 7D with me, a Canon 7D, and this has a built-in flash, but normally when you guys are taking nightclub photos, you're going to use a separate speed light or flash, okay? And both in camera, okay, in camera and also on the flash unit itself, you can adjust the FEC value, or the flash exposure compensation. Now, I'm not going to describe how to use your camera or how to use your flash. That's why you guys have instruction manuals. But the main thing is learn how to use it, learn how to adjust it. Now, the more important thing I want to discuss for this episode is realizing how that works with your ISO and the reason why it's so important to understand. So let's say you take a shot of a subject. Bang, you have it. Let's say you have the flash unit attached. Take a shot. And you notice that, okay, the background looks good, there's a lot of ambient lighting, but your subject doesn't look really lighted up. What I would do is keep the same exact ISO, shutter speed, and aperture settings on your camera. If everything looks good except that the subject isn't lit enough, and go into your camera, if you're using an on-camera flash, go into your camera and change your flash exposure compensation. Increase it a bit so that now your subject is going to be lit up a little bit more. So you don't have to change anything else, just increase that FEC value. And on the flip side, if your subject was lit up too much, then decrease the value. And that's the easiest thing to do. You don't have to fiddle with your flashing it. Do it through your camera. Okay, and look into your instruction manual to learn how to do that. Now, what's more important here? This is the understanding of how it works with ISO. Because let's say your shutter speed and your aperture are perfect. You have the right clarity through your aperture and you're capturing the motion that you want through the appropriate shutter speed. But now, you know, it's understanding how the ambient light, how ISO affects the ambient lighting and the FEC and how it affects your foreground, your subject, how your subject looks in regards to being lit up enough or not lit up enough by your flash unit. And this is a quick and dirty explanation of how to balance ISO with FEC or flash exposure compensation. Now again, as I mentioned in the beginning, everything is a gray area. Nothing is black and white. So what I described to you, there is going to be some overlap, and I'll explain it a little bit further. If you take a photo and the background is lit up very well, and you just want to focus on the foreground, your subject, when you're using your flash, use the flash exposure compensation to adjust. So you're not going to touch anything in the background. That ISO is already lighting up the ambient lighting good enough, so keep it. And then just change your FEC value. Now let's assume your subject is lit up very well through your flash. Now the opposite applies. Keep your FEC value on your camera, the flash exposure compensation, keep it as is, and increase your ISO. Okay, so what that's going to do now is, let's assume that your subject is lit up very well with your flash, you like how it looks in your camera, but the ambient lighting is not being captured, or you could increase the lighting in the background if you wanted to, increase the ISO. So it's playing with that FCE value and the ISO to kind of come up with that perfect balance. So if your background is not bright enough, increase your ISO. If your subject is not lit up enough, increase your your flash exposure compensation. FEC, sorry, I said FCE initially. Flash exposure compensation. Now, it's not black and white. So if you do increase your flash exposure compensation, your FEC value, that will affect your background a little bit. And if you increase your ISO setting, that will affect your subject or your foreground a little bit too. So it's not black and white, but you get the idea. And generally it works out very well. So keep that in mind. If you want to increase the light in your background, ISO, increase the ISO. Your subject, flash exposure compensation. Now those are only two elements. Now, and don't take those as golden rules. What I mean is, you still have shutter to worry about, you still have aperture to worry about, and your understanding of lighting, what's going on in the club. So there's so many factors. But play with those two settings, and that can really make the difference. If you have a decent understanding of shutter, aperture, now playing around with your ISO and flash exposure compensation will really help. Now here's another tip though. Besides the flash exposure compensation and dealing with your ISO, when you guys take photos of people, you need to be able to switch those settings right away. So two things apply here. You need to understand your camera very, very well. You need to know how to change your settings instantly. It should be like the back of your hand. You know everything. So the way I normally approach it is this. If I'm taking a photo of a group of people, what I'll do is I'll snap the shot. Imagine I have my flash on here or off-camera flash. Snap the shot, take the shot. I'll take a look. And I won't show it to them right away. Let's say the photo, it's blurry or the foreground wasn't lit up enough. What I'll do is, before I show it to them, I'll take a shot and I'll look at it. If it's not good, what I'll do is, all right, hey guys, let's take another photo. And by the time I get my camera up, so I'm taking a look at my photo, by the time I get my camera up, I am already switching the settings. I know my camera enough so that I can switch the settings. And by the time I get it up to here, I'm pretty much there. I have my new settings in place. Maybe I've increased my flash exposure compensation, or maybe I've increased the ISO or decreased it, whatever it is, and I'm ready to take the second shot, okay? So that comes with understanding your camera and experience. What do I mean by experience? You'll realize, do I need to increase or decrease my flash exposure compensation, my ISO, shutter speed, aperture? And unfortunately, it's just like many, you know, different sports. For instance, if any of you have ever surfed, surfing, it takes about 2 to 3